Hello everyone in the vinyl community. This is Mark from Westchester, and I am about to start my sixth video in a series of my album collection. And we're halfway through the B's, so I'm going to get right into it because I got a lot. Elvin Bishop's Let It Flow is my first album, and Elvin Bishop is mostly known for his work with Capricorn Records and also the big hit Fooled Around and Fell in Love, but I don't like that song. I like this stuff. I like Traveling Shoes, which is on this album. And looking at the liner notes, believe it or not, Sly Stone is on this album. Yes, Sly Stone. And Charlie Daniels, Dickie Betts from the Allman Brothers, and Philip Iberg is in the band, actually. Philip Iberg's known as a Windham Hill artist. I had no idea he was actually in Elvin Bishop's band. Elvin Bishop originally was a forming member of the Paul Butterfield Blues Band. Traveling Shoes is on this. Great tune. Sounds like Allman Brothers with the dual guitars. Really nice stuff. Juke Joint Jump is the album that I have, the other album that I have of his, and that song in particular is one of my faves. I like the humor that this guy seems to have. And yeah, Southern rock, you know, a lot of people don't like it, but I like a lot of it. And you'll find that out as you go through my collection, you see. Next I have The Bitter End Years. This is a compilation put out on Roxbury Records. I don't know much about it, but if you can see all these people, I don't know if you can see, just hold it there for a second. Part of this is folk music. Part of this is comedy, and part of this is rock, and it's just people who had played there. There's a couple live things here, but I like the album quite a bit. It's got, you know, I like a montage of things thrown together, and good playing, good songs. Okay, I have a bloopers album, The Best of the Bloopers. Don't know much about the album. I know I listened to it once. But I have no idea if, I don't even know if I laughed while I listened to this thing, but I still have it. Blondie, I have The Best of Blondie. Debbie Harry is one of my favorite singers. She really knew how to deliver a song, and her on video, man, she was perfect for those MTV video thingies. And I really like the song Heart of Glass, and The Tide is High, and Rapture. And Hanging on the Telephone. I like Blondie. Next, I have Booker T and the MGs. This is a Taiwanese release of the album. They were the Stax house band. They played with everybody from Otis Redding to Sam and Dave. And they had their own hits. Green Onions being the big one. It's a pretty good sounding album. You know, the Taiwanese pressings aren't all that great, but it's good enough that I have it. I have no idea if it's worth anything or not. I don't worry about stuff like that too much. Okay, I have the one and only Blind Faith album with Eric Clapton, Steve Winwood, Ginger Baker, and Rick Gretsch. And the story is that Eric Clapton, after leaving Cream, decided to put something together with Stevie Winwood, and then Ginger Baker sort of fell into it. It lasted for about a year. Came out with some good tunes on this album. Can't Find My Way Home, Well All Right, Sea of Joy. Sea of Joy. I love Sea of Joy. I like that album. It's kind of weird sounding. It sounds almost like it's recorded in somebody's garage. But anyway. The Bothy Band. These are musicians from Ireland, and boy, this is a wonderful album. I even wrote a little sticker up here saying how much I enjoyed it. I would get this, 1975. I have a few David Bowie albums, before I say the wrong title. This is the Hunky Dory album, and this has, you know, Changes and Oh You Pretty Things, which I love. And that's produced by Ken Scott. And Ken Scott produced Supertramp. He was actually the one of the last engineers on Beatle albums, and he produced the Dixie Dregs too. Station to Station. When this came out, I liked this album a great deal. I was never a gigantic Bowie fan, and even though I lived near Philadelphia, I didn't really dig those Philadelphia sounding albums. But I dug those two, and this, which is a 2016 release, is really, really good. This is Bowie at the Beeb. This was really well thought out, well planned, well executed. I can't say enough about the sound of this album. It is such a clean pressing. And this booklet is, you know, it's really nice. It's all shiny and stuff. Look at that. Look at those pictures. A lot of information. I've listened to all these albums. The stuff that he did with the Spiders from Mars, I guess that's his backing band, you know. In any case, yeah, here's what's on it. Thinking of Mick Ronson, that's my man, Mick Ronson, the guitar dude, who actually did a lot of the arrangements for the songs. Got very little credit for that. Good album. Now you may be wondering, what is this background music? Well, the background music here is Brand X. And Brand X was a band that was around and just got back together this year and back on tour. This is Unorthodox Behavior. I bought this back when I was 15 years old in 76. Phil Collins is the drummer on the first few albums and then maybe the fourth or fifth or something. Very good fusion music. I have a few of these albums. I don't have more rock and roll, but I do have Livestock. I love the sound of all these albums. I love the playing. The tunes on most of them are really good, if not great. The moods that this band can play and the recordings are really splendiferous. This is Product. And this one was simultaneously recorded along with Do They Hurt? Like almost two bands playing. One had Phil Collins playing, and the other had another drummer whom I don't remember the name of. One was a little bit more commercial than the other. If you like instrumental music, you like this kind of sound, turn this up a teeny bit. This is the title cut, Unorthodox Behavior. I just think it's really great stuff. Next, David Bromberg. David Bromberg is known as a folk musician who could play incredible guitar and violin. He is now a violin maker down in Wilmington, Delaware. He's played with everybody on the scene. And what can you say about David Bromberg? He's just wonderful. I was very lucky to go down to Wilmington and play with him in a little jam session. He was so very nice to me. Let me play his guitar. And I'm a Beatles fan. And he says, let's play a Beatles tune. And I said, yeah. And he said, you can't do that. And I'm like, oh my God, I don't know that song. Showed it to me. We played it. It was fun. It was. Yes, this is his Demon in Disguise album. This has Sharon on it. I love Sharon. Well, I love the song Sharon. And the Jug Band song is great too. This was put out in 72. This is the best of David Bromberg. This has The Hold Up on it, which he wrote with George Harrison. I'm not going to say it's a great song. You can listen to it. You can judge for yourself. That's all I'll say. Let me see if there's anything else on here. The Newly Highway Blues is really good. Great instrumental. Kicking tune. This is Midnight on the Water. Released blah, blah, blah at some point. 70-something. 75. And I believe finally of the Brombergs, I have this live one. How late will you play? Till or something like that. Play Till, T-I-L. He had a band, the David Bromberg band, and they played, they were such a fun sort of like swinging rock band. The clarinet player, trombone, and songs on here like Such a Night, You know, such a nice, sweet confusion in the moonlight. You came here with your old friend Jim, and I'm stealing you away from him. But if I don't do it, somebody else will. David Bromberg, he's a gem. The Crazy World of Arthur Brown. This I bought because of the song Fire. And it's a good album. It's got his voice, the one thing is his voice, he's got the same delivery on every tune, and it's just as crazy as, you know, I am the God of Hellfire! And he's like that all the way through the album. But, you know, I bought the album, it's good. Another Brown, and one of my heroes, the funk meister himself, James Brown. And I only have a few of his albums. This one is Live at the Apollo number 2. I especially love this because of the long version of There Was a Time. It's like a whole album side. This is wonderful stuff. Considered to be one of the better of the greatest hits albums. This is the best of James Brown. Here are the hits. And I also have Black Caesar. I picked this up relatively recently. I heard it being played at my favorite music store, the Mad Platter in Westchester. Yeah, I gotta put a plug in for those guys, because you know what? They know what they're doing there at the Mad Platter. Go see them. See them, buy their records. Anyway, Black Caesar, good album. Not the best I've heard from James Brown, but I liked what I heard in the store, so I bought it. Now to Jackson Brown. I have his first 3 albums. And Saturate Before Using is not the title of this album. It's just called Jackson Brown. But that up there says, oh, Saturate Before Using, right? Yeah, okay. It just happened to be on this water bag here, and there's a whole story about it. And so, anyway, Jamaica Say You Will, Doctor My Eyes, Rock Me on the Water, great tunes. Great tunes, great album. But I think a better album is this one, For Every Man. This is my favorite Jackson Brown album. It's got great players on it who play really well together. Take It Easy, the song that he wrote with Glenn Frey. I think it was Glenn Frey. It was either Glenn or Don Felder. I think it's Glenn Frey. It's a better version than the Eagles because of David Lindley's playing and the fact that they fade the song out. They fade the song out into the next song, which is Our Lady of the Well. And it's a perfect fade out. I heard it on the radio when I was a kid. I called up the DJ and I said, man, that was a great fade you did. He says, I wish I did it. It was on the album. I was like, oh. Also, Redneck Friend. Redneck Friend, a great tune. And I saw in the credits here, Rockaday Johnny. Rockaday Johnny happens to be Elton John. And it's a kicking song. Pretty Little One, How Has It All Begun? Teaching You How to Walk, But You're Already on the Run. Great album. I love that album. All songs on it. Great. Late for the Sky. The album after For Every Man. And I like this album. Fountain of Sorrow is a great album. Great album. It's a great song. Late for the Sky is kind of like Redneck Friend. This here is influenced by a Magritte painting, and I see down at the bottom it says cover concept by Jackson Brown, If It's All Reet with Magritte. Anyway, okay, next. I have a couple of David Brubeck albums. I bought this just because I wanted to read the copy. I'm sure I know some of the tunes on this. I don't know this album all that well. They just take a bunch of tunes that in 1954 they're playing live. Paul Desmond is playing the alto sax, and of course Dave Brubeck is piano. And Time Out, which is the tour de force that everybody heard. When they heard Take 5, they said, you can't dance to this song. Well, you have a third leg, I guess, to dance with that song. I don't know. Okay. I have one Bill Bruford album, one of a kind. I just picked this up mainly because I love Bill Bruford as a drummer. I'm not crazy about the album. My group got to open up for him in Philadelphia, and he was very kind to us, and what a wonderful drummer. We have a few Gary Burton albums. Gary Burton, the Vibes player. Oops, here's the first side. Here we go. Picture this is on ECM. I like just about everything he does, even though I don't have all his albums. The new Quartet album, I particularly like. Again, on ECM. And you can see what's on here. Just about everything on here I can sit and listen to with interest. And an earlier one that he did, this is like a compilation actually, of the stuff that he did on Atlantic. It's a two-record set, Turn of the Century. See some of the tunes. Really nice. Hey, I got just one more here. My last one of the Bees. Kate Bush. The Whole Story. This is a another compilation album. I really love the song Wuthering Heights. Remember Hounds of Love from the day. Babushka, Babushka. Quite an artist. Quite a great artist. I don't have any more of her albums because basically everything that's on here is enough for me. Okay, so that's it. I will hopefully be back sooner than later with the C's. If you have any questions, thoughts, did I get something wrong? Let me know. I am a musician, not a historian. But I love doing this, and I hope you liked it too. See you soon. Bye.